Hi, Jonathan here. Today is 21st of December 2020 and time right now is 12:24 a.m. It's just after midnight. This YouTube came out a little bit late because I was out the whole day yesterday and out the whole day. Basically out the whole day on Saturday and Sunday. Okay, because today is Monday. All right, so let's take a look at what's going on in the market. So do remember one thing that there are still major things that you need to look out for. Mainly, Uncle DJT still refused to acknowledge whatever election that everyone has accepted, including the Supreme Court, but doesn't matter. But this week, what to expect? This week, you should be expecting stimulus package because as of right now, they are still being put to vote. They have an emergency emergency package to make sure the government's still running and it expires. Lunchtime later today. Oops, sorry. So it expired later in a short while. So in 12 hours from now. So right now, in 12 hours, they will have to get the government budget and the stimulus at the same time. Okay, so watch out for that. So right now is also the vaccine is being rolling out in a few more countries. So everyone now saying that don't have to worry anymore about the flu. Unfortunately, the infection rate and the casualty are still going higher. Tesla, that's the big news. So I'll be sharing a little bit more about Tesla in a short while due to one request to talk about Tesla in a short while. And economic. And of course, the Brexit. So basically, right now, do remember one thing that we are this week. If you take a look at Forex Factory calendar, Monday, totally no orange. Tuesday, only got one orange and that is the GDP, okay? Wednesday, look at this, you only got one Canada news, okay? And of course, the normal yellow color. Thursday, look at it, only got four record and mainly one of them is German. German on Thursday, December 24th is on holiday. So do expect that if you're trading the Euro dollar or pound dollar or European index, expect to be quiet. And Friday, wow, so many gray color. Australia gray color, New Zealand gray color, Swiss gray color, European gray, French gray color, German gray color, Italy gray color, London gray color, Canada gray color, United States gray color. Wow, why so many gray color? What's going on Thursday, December 25th? What's wrong with December 25th? Is it something to do with ho, ho, ho? No. Christmas, of course. So do remember one thing that this week, the only significant day for this week in terms of traders is December 21st. Because on December 21st, it is what we call a winter solstice. Is where some of us get to eat the tang yuan. Whatever ball you call it. I forgot what you call it. Okay, but basically it's sort of a significant that you're older by 1 year. It is also the longest night of the year for the Northern Hemisphere, but it's also the what Saturn and one more planet conjunct. There's a lot of things going on December 31st. But for traders, what is important for December 21st is Tesla. Tesla was actually in the S&P on Friday, last Friday. So Monday, they are starting to trade inside S&P. Okay, so which is why on Tesla, you notice the volume spiked so much higher and the price went up over the last few weeks, mainly because of the movement in Tesla. But remember one thing, now that Tesla is part of S&P, the price range, you won't see it here. Let me change this to linear scale. The price changes in S&P right now, which is, I think, about more than 10%, just S&P alone, just Tesla alone. The price movement of Tesla will now affect S&P index. Last time, price collapsed right here, or price gap up right here. There's nothing to do with S&P. It's only the price of Tesla. But right now, the price movement of Tesla will affect S&P index. So take note. And if you notice, 695 to, I don't know what's the low. Let me check with this chart. The low, 626 and 695. So there's a difference of about $70. A price movement of $70 on Friday alone. And this, if it's in S&P index, will affect S&P movement. So what does it mean? It means that if you are going to trade the US index, especially S&P, Tesla is one of the chart you should be opening apart from Apple. Because Apple is also another one. Okay, so this will, Apple, let's just put it this way, the movement of Apple is not as crazy as Tesla. So Tesla will be more volatile. So you should be opening Tesla chart and take a look. Okay, so now the question is, I got a few questions right now asking, Monday, should we buy Tesla because it's part of S&P? Do remember, whatever I share is my personal opinion. If you like to trade, please do your own due diligence. Take note. Everyone already know Tesla is in S&P on Monday. So if you're thinking of buying Tesla on Monday, you are already way, way last one to know. Everyone that's been trading already know. It's been announced 3-4 weeks ago. That's why the price has been spiking higher. So if you're thinking now only to buy, you're the last one. Okay? Some of you said that, hey, is it time for you to take profit? Let's just put it this way. If you are taking profit, congratulations, that means you are already having profit. Unless you haven't buy. Because any price you buy right now, it closed at a day high, you should be in profit. Just a question of how much. Okay? Now, what should you do? In my personal opinion, if you look at the volume on Friday, you notice the volume spiked are one of the highest apart from here. Okay? Apart from here. But do you notice that the volume spike has been tremendous? So what do you expect? You won't expect that on Friday because it closed at a high, at the highest price. So you will expect the bull run should still continue. And if the volume continue to spike, mainly because a lot of people have to put Tesla as part of their ETF index, you have to remember one thing, that as long as there's high volume, your perception is more people should be buying Tesla. And if more people are buying Tesla, that means they are buying pressure. If they are buying pressure, what do you expect the stock price to be doing? Price go higher. Am I right? So on Monday, it is normal to expect price of Tesla, the volume of Tesla to be high. That's granted because it's like first day of IPO. So it's first day of index. Everyone, there's a hype right there. And you must expect the price of Tesla to go higher. But what if it's not? That means if the volume is very high, but the price of Tesla couldn't go higher, doesn't that tell you there are some distribution? Because if everyone is going to buy, there has to be buying pressure. If there's buying pressure, the price has to go higher. But if there's tremendous volume, the buying pressure can be met by a selling pressure and the price couldn't go higher, that smells distribution. Am I right? Can it continue to go higher after that? Maybe Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday? Thursday half day, remember? Thursday half day? Friday market close? Stock market in US close? It's possible. It's possible. But what I'm saying that if there are distribution, it could be a cautious sign for you, and perhaps if you are having position, you might want to set a very close trailing stop and says that I'm done. The price is at a high. It is obviously overbought. Why don't I wait for the price to go lower? Right? Can it continue to go higher? Yeah, it is always possible. But then, why don't you look for another opportunity? That's what I'm saying. Why? Because if you take a look, I'm going to show you a chart of S&P. Okay? S&P. Now, if you look at it this way, we had a fantastic bull run since March this year. Like it or not, this is one of the strongest bull market ever. Look at all this bull market. Okay? Look at all this bull market. We never had this strong bull market. Maybe you want to give a partial credit to Uncle DJT, or maybe he claimed full credit. It doesn't matter. But what I'm saying is March, We are right now, December 21st. 9 months. 9 months. 9 months. Market has went up tremendously for three quarters. And right now, we're coming to the end of the last quarter of 2020. Do anyone need window dressing? The window dressing has been going on for the last 9 months. I don't think so. You need any more window dressing. Okay? Now, we talk in terms of technical then. If we talk in terms of technical, if we change just use a simple MACD and RSI. This is a standard 14 RSI and standard 12.26.9 MACD. You will see that there's nothing much. Nothing much. Okay? We are close to overbought. And MACD doesn't tell overbought oversold, but MACD is at the top. So there's nothing much in daily chart that tells us anything. There is no bearish divergence, both not an obvious bearish divergence in RSI and MACD. But if I change this to a weekly candle, granted, this has been going on for weeks, granted that. Okay, in RSI, there's nothing much. It's weekly, it is not overbought. There's no bearish divergence. But if you take a look at weekly MACD, I'll zoom out. You will notice that right now, the blue line in MACD is the highest ever. In fact, it's even higher than February, March, pre-COVID, pre-flu. Can't use the word. Okay? So, we dropped the most the moment the flu strikes. But right now, we are way higher than pre-flu. And look at this. We have never gone higher. This is a weekly candle since 2008. If I change this to a monthly chart, you can't see. Okay? It is the highest ever also. And monthly chart, there is a bearish divergence. But bearish divergence on monthly chart, I hardly use it because it just plays out in months, which is irrelevant. But look at it. What does it mean? It basically, MACD is an indicator comprises of moving average. So what this tells us right now, that the separation right there and the movement right there basically tells us that the moving average are going ballistically higher. Which is, looking at the price, you already know it's going ballistically higher. So there is a projection whereby the price right now is ballistically up. Very simple. How do you know a sign of ballistic up? Very simple. Is that any of your friends are now interested? You have never thought that they are interested in trading. Suddenly, they are interested in trading. Do you notice that right now, a lot of value investor trainer start telling them that how many of their students already make tremendous amount of money? Do you notice that right now, there are a lot of training programs teaching you how to be a professional trader or how to be a trader in just like that? Sign up for my class. You can make money starting tomorrow. In fact, if you sign up for my class, who knows, next week you'll be a multi-millionaire. Financial freedom is within your hand. You hear a lot of this right now, right? That's a sign of euphoria. I'm not saying that the taking classes or training is not good. I'm saying that I am a trainer too. I'll be offering a training program. It'll be different, so don't worry about that. Worry about that because I'm coming out with a training program too. So what I'm saying right now is there's euphoria. It is like being in the stock market is a sure win thing. And if I'm not in the market, everyone else are making money without me. That's the euphoria that I believe you are seeing it at this very moment. In fact, you go into Facebook, you can't miss lots of advertisement right there. That's what I'm saying. But I'm not saying that the market is going to collapse. I'm not saying that the market is going to drop. But I'm saying that right now, it is dangerous to long the market, even though it can continue to go higher. But I'm not saying that you can short right now because the signal are not there yet. So that's what I'm saying. So I have been waiting patiently over the last 2 to 3 weeks, waiting already, just waiting for the right signal for a bearish signal to show up. Basically, what are a bearish signal? Well, very simple. I'm now waiting for the right place, which we have. I'm now waiting for the right shape, which we don't have. I'm also waiting for after the right shape show up, I need to wait for the right size, which hasn't shown up. The bearish candle, like shooting star, or even engulfing, did try to show up on Friday. We did almost had a bearish engulfing, but at the last moment, they did save it. So this one, can some of you say it's a hanging man? Yeah, it is a hanging man. But personally, I don't like a hanging man candle because it is not as accurate per se for trading as compared to a bearish shooting star. So I prefer, in order for a shooting star to show up, the price has to go up first. Am I right? Think about the price action for a shooting star. Before a shooting star appear, the price must be going up first before it can turn lower. Then only can form a shooting star. Alternative, the price has to engulf the previous candle. That means the price has to be up and sell down the entire candle. So which these two candles, these two scenarios, hasn't shown up. It would be great if we have volume, but so far we haven't. So if you like to have this type of indicator to give you a early warning, you can always download the MoneyPot Lite. Okay, MoneyPot Lite, I've recently upgraded it, extend the expiry date to March 15. This should be the last version of, this should be the last extension of the current version, mainly because I am working on a updated engine. The graduates are already enjoying the new engine for the full version of MoneyPot, but you guys will be getting the MoneyPot Lite. Just go to Facebook Gathering of Traders, click on Files, and then read on this document, and you can get it. In fact, I posted it in Gathering of Traders 2-3 days ago. Somewhere, right here, December 18th. Also posted in Telegram. So now, for you as a trader, what can you see? Actually, it is very simple. If there are bearish candle, you will see it in Telegram the first thing in the morning. So this is free. Gathering of Traders Telegram group is free. When you wake up in the morning or sometime in the morning, suddenly you notice a few things. You will notice that there could be a lot of bearish signal world indices, a lot of them. That could be a clue. Or suddenly you see a lot of shooting star. That will be a clue. Now you understand why I use this daily signal center every single day. Over the last few days, what has been moving? Over the last few days, what has been moving is crypto. That's how I use the daily market broadcast to tell me, hey, today what is moving? Basically, I know that straight away, oh, Forex and index, no one is playing. Gold, silver is selling down, so gold must follow silver. But the main thing everyone is looking is at crypto. Crypto has been going up like crazy. Bitcoin, Litecoin, Ethereum has been going up like crazy. Okay? Now, there's a reason why I follow the process. What I'm saying right now is, let me check if I'm missing anything. Okay. What you want is a candle in Tesla that looks like this. That looks like this. High volume, but the candle looks like this. That means if there's a high volume, you expect the buying pressure, but yet the price didn't go up much. That tells you a sign of distribution. Is Bitcoin a sign of distribution? Let's just put it this way. You will notice that Bitcoin is following very similarly. Look at this. The last time MACD was this high was during the 2017 bubble, where everyone was in a hype. We are right now higher, I agree. Look at RSI, we are also at a crazy high. So I agree. So right now, can it go down? There's no bearish candle yet. But obviously, if you're thinking of buying right now, you're buying at a very overbought. Remember, the mantra of trading, buy low, sell high. Can you sell high, buy low, short? There is no trade. No signal to short as of this moment. There is no signal to short. There is bearish divergence in daily candle in MACD and RSI, but there is no turn yet. you want at least the blue line or RSI to turn down, at least turn down to below 70, or this blue line starts turning down, there is a probability of shorting. But remember, you are doing a counter trend trade. You are trying to short on a uptrend. So take note. So you notice there are different picture of coming in. Okay, so few things. Euro pound. There was a request to talk about Euro pound because this was what was shared last week. Remember last Sunday, I talked about Euro pound. Mainly Euro pound, there is a bearish candle. However, there is no opportunity to short, mainly because that's the problem with analyzing if the candle shows up on Friday. It is hard to short, mainly because you need the price to go lower. But the problem is Saturday, Sunday, where Forex are closed. So when Monday, when the market opens, Euro pound gap down opened right here, which is not a surprise because right now it's all Brexit, Brexit, Brexit. Okay. However, with the gap down, it makes things hard to short. Yeah, on a hindsight, overall, it did go lower. But there wasn't an opportunity. I was looking to short. But because of the gap down, yeah, I just practically gave up. It gap down a lot, not gap down a little. That's a lot. So practically, on a hindsight, on Tuesday, it did went massive sell down. There is not much of a trading opportunity to short. So I didn't short, even though I did highlight that, because mainly because of the gap. I'm sharing this mainly so that you understand trading. Sometimes people say, yeah, can short, make money. Yeah, but usually if you notice, talking and trading, there's slight difference. There's slight difference in that. Actually, not slight difference, a lot of difference. So which is why traders, we are able to know whether certain trainers are talking or certain trainers are just not talking. I don't want to disclaimer, okay? Don't want to share too much. So what I'm saying is, one thing is, watch the chart. And right now, not only that, if you take a look at Germany DAX, all the arrow is money pot light, okay? So you can get it for free. If you take a look, Germany DAX is not as bullish as US. Granted, I agree. But do you notice one thing, that on a weekly candle, if we start to turn lower, which we are right now, there is a possible bearish divergence right here in MACD. Price are making higher high, but indicator are making a lower high. That's a bearish divergence. So what I'm saying right now, overall in summary, basically today, there's nothing much of a trade signal, because there's nothing much. Practically, there's nothing much. Usually, prior to major holidays, and Christmas and New Year is considered a very major holidays. Chinese New Year is not considered a major holiday around the world for traders. Usually before a major holiday, like Christmas, usually the market tends to go higher. Gold tends to go higher usually prior to Christmas. So watch out for that. Check historical price. However, the problem is, not only this time we got not only Christmas, we also got New Year. So which means that we got prior Christmas, market tends to go higher. We also got prior New Year because it is a quarter window dressing. Not only quarter, not only half, but the entire year-end window dressing. So market is expected to go higher this week and next week. However, what I'm saying is we have three quarters for the market to have gone higher. So any window dressing can already be done over the last three quarters. I mean, if you talk about all these fund managers doing window dressing, they work very hard for the last three quarters. They don't have to work very hard for the last 2 weeks of the year. Am I right? So is there a possibility for the price to go lower? The risk is there. The risk is there. That's what I'm saying. So which is why, even though right now I'm not aggressively trading, but I am watching the chart every single day, I just don't look at too small of a time frame. I pay extra attention to the daily candle, waiting for bearish candle. That's what I'm doing. So hopefully you get the hint. Now you understand what am I watching for so that you're able to take note. Will I alert all of you if there is a bearish signal that I've seen? Definitely. I'll broadcast it in the Telegram. I'll give my market update right here. I do give my market update right here once in a while. Okay. So which is why you need to join this group. Telegram Gathering of Traders. Search for Gathering of Traders. You will find it. So right now, am I expecting profit taking? Am I expecting a crash? No, I'm not expecting a crash. I am expecting just a major profit taking, mainly because we are a little bit too expensive right now. And the price is good for profit taking, but not yet. That's the overall summary, which I hope you get drilled down. The other one I am looking for is US dollars. Yes, US dollar collapsed like crazy. Where is it? This is my the other profile that... right here. The other one I'm looking for is US dollars. US dollars right now, there's a massive collapse. It is a massive collapse. I am now waiting for, there is no bullish divergence yet. So I am not waiting for bullish divergence because not there yet. But I'm waiting for if the price do go up right now and then start to have a sell down, I'm looking for the next sell down to see if it can form a higher low. Then we have a shoulder, head, and possible shoulder. So I'm waiting to see if there's a possible shoulder. It won't happen tomorrow. It won't happen Tuesday, Wednesday. It will happen the earliest, because to form a shoulder, it will be early January. That will be the earliest. So watching that out very closely. Okay. So overall, nothing much to share, except I hope you get the hint. I still wait for daily candle. Watch the candle very, very closely. Jonathan signing off. Have a Merry Christmas. Bye.